Welcome in the name of Jesus, the Savior of the world. We are gathered to worship the plan Christ crucified and risen, to remember before God our sister Catherine. Give thanks for the life. Commend her to our merciful Redeemer and to comfort one another. When we are baptized in Christ Jesus, we are baptized into his death. We are buried, therefore, with him by baptism into death, so that Christ was raised from the dead by the glory of the Father. In my own life. For if we have been united with him in a death like this, we shall certainly be united with him in a resurrection like this. I should stand and join in the singing of God.
There's a season for everything and a time for every matter. Well, we have all kinds of memories. We have all kinds of images. We have lots of pictures. We have things that we did together that sustain us and keep us going. But there's nothing new. So we won't be around for anything else. Now it'll only be three systems doing the crazy stuff that systems put together, not the four systems anymore. All of that changes. Sorry, grandma will be around for the things that will be born in the ground. Just won't be. That's what makes death so hard. But the loss of the things that we anticipate, the loss of the things we expect, and no longer. There was another relationship which sustained her in the midst of all of that. That was the relationship she had with her relationship. Relationship established in the waters of the Holy Baptism many, many years ago. Relationship sustained in this community of faithful people. Relationship sustained as she sang in the choir, as she received communion at God's table, as she heard the prayers and the words that were linked to her. Relationship that is not by the promises, by the experience of God. The promises of Christ, which were given to her in baptism, have now been received fully by her as she enters into the heavenly place. Now, I learned this morning as I checked into the casket that we not have to bring our own coffee when we go to the heavenly places, or at least a particular kind of coffee. This is a sort of startup, it's going to be your coffee. But there is this moment of expectation that Catherine is now alive at the table. That had been prepared for all generations, for all of us. She now gets to experience what we still anticipate. She now gets to receive what God has promised. And the sadness that comes with knowing that someone is not with us is connect the life of knowing that she is no longer suffering the ills that come with life on earth, experiencing the joys that come with life. Child of God, a child of the Heavenly Father, now gets to experience that relationship more deeply than we do on her story. So, yes, the pain of Kathy's departure from our midst is big. The joy of knowing that Kathy is receiving the gift that God has for her and for all of us sustains us in the midst of our suffering. Same children of the Thank you.
I believe in God, Father Almighty, Creator of heaven and earth. I believe in Jesus Christ, our only Son, who was conceived by the Holy Spirit, consoled Martha and Mary for their distress. Our dear to Boston, Martha, that they tried to choose those in your mercy. Jesus, man of sorrow, wept the grave of last of the friend. Comfort us the more in your mercy. Jesus, firstborn of the new creation, you raised the dead. Give to our sister life eternal. In your mercy. Jesus, friend of sinners, promise paradise to repent and thee. Bring happy to the joys of heaven. In your mercy. Jesus, wellspring of life, you wash our sister in baptism and anoint her with the Holy Spirit. Give her communion to all your sins. In your mercy. Jesus, bread of God, encourage Matthew at the table on earth. Welcome her at your table for the love. In your mercy. Jesus, bright morning star, comfort us in our sorrows and the death of death. Let our faith hear consolation and eternal life come. In your mercy. Of all grace, we give you thanks because by his death, our Savior Jesus Christ, the Lord of God, by his resurrection, open the kingdom of heaven to all believers. Make us certain that because we live, we shall live also. That neither death nor life, nor things present nor things to come, shall be able to separate us from your love, which is in Christ Jesus our Lord. Live and reign with you, the Holy Spirit, one God, now and forever. Let us spend happy in the mercy of God, our Maker and Redeemer. In your hands, the merciful Savior, we command your servant happy. Acknowledge, we humbly beseech you, a sheep of your own fold, a lamb of your own flock, a sinner of your own redeemer. Receive her into the arms of your mercy and into the blessed rest of everlasting peace, and to the glorious company of the saints of God. Now may the God of peace who brought again from the dead our Lord Jesus, the great shepherd of the sheep, by the blood of the eternal covenant, make you complete in everything good, so that you may do God's will. Working in you that which is well pleasing in God's sight. Jesus Christ, will be the glory of forever and ever. Let's go forth in peace. Thank you, Christ. Thank you.
This concludes the service.